It was the Monday after Thanksgiving. You know, it was just a normal, regular school day.
Shots fired. Hayes High School, outside the lobby, got subjects down.
I felt my entire body go numb.
All right, they're on the way, okay?
Please hurry.
Okay, ma'am. We got five down at this time.
A rapid succession of gunfire.
Every time the gun goes off, someone's falling.
12 deadly seconds before Principal Bill Bond reaches 14-year-old Michael Carneal.
And there was a break in the rhythm of the gunfire. And so I thought he's changing clips. You've got to get the gun before he changes clips. You've just got to get the gun.
There are no words as Carneal hands over the gun. Sophomore Missy Jenkins is hit. So are seven others, including the girl lying next to her.
I remember hearing my algebra teacher saying over and over again, she's not going to make it.
17-year-old Jessica James will die in surgery. 14-year-old freshman Nicole Hadley is also a victim. Casey Steger, a sophomore, a member of the band, is rushed to the hospital. Sabrina Steger has just finished her shift there and learns the news when she makes it home.
The answer machine is beeping, and it was my son saying, come to Lourdes Hospital immediately. And I knew then.
Carneal makes a full confession, no explanation, just an admission.
I put in the clip and turned off the safety and cocked it. And then just started firing.
There is forgiveness and unprecedented grief. Three funerals. Where students sign coffins instead of yearbooks.
Melissa Joyce Jenkins.
And while there are triumphs along the way, there are voids that can never be filled. What happened here is one of the first high school shootings in U.S. history. How and when to move forward falls on Principal Bill Bond. He chooses to bring students back the very next day.
If we had closed this school, it would have been for only one reason, fear. And it would have put the shooter in charge.
But it will be months until Missy Jenkins, unable to walk, returns.
Here it was 5 months after it happened, and everyone else had kind of gotten through the stages that I was just beginning, going back to school for the first time, going back to the lobby where it happened.
Things she notices are different. In the wake of tragedy, local law enforcement has publicly debated school safety.
We can put up all the fences in the world, all the metal detectors, and 20 policemen in this place of doom, we still have an incident tomorrow.
In the end, officers and teachers come together, setting a precedent that other schools across the country will soon follow. The school is secured with just two points of entry. There are teachers at each of those entrances checking backpacks, and there's name tags for visitors. Later, some of the country's first school resource officers.
I felt like Heath was doing a lot, as much as they could, to make us safe after it happened.
But for Sabrina Steger, who has lost her daughter, the changes come too late.
I couldn't protect her. I couldn't be there with her. And it still hurts as much as it did that day.
Casey's name is one of three that appear on this memorial. It's meant to be a place of reflection and remembrance, but for Principal Bill Bond, it's a difficult reminder.
I just think about it took 12 seconds to get that gun. If it had only taken eight, the names, it wouldn't have been on there.
In just a matter of weeks, it will be 17 years since the Heath High School shooting. Now tomorrow, I'll have more with the people that lived that tragedy, how they've coped, and how they've honored the lives lost. That's coming up tomorrow at 5 o'clock. I'm Lauren Adams, WLKY News.
I think gunfire.
Where's the shots fired? Where?
In the lobby.
Where? In the lobby of the high school?
In the lobby of the high school.
It was a really, really horrible thing to have to sit and watch.
Ma'am, is anyone injured?
I think so.
I just laid there and watched that until the ambulances came.
What happened in the lobby of this West Kentucky high school would change a nation.
21. We got five down at this time.
Three students shot to death, five injured.
Whatever it takes to bring your children home safely, that's what I'm for.
Because on December 1st, 1997, Sabrina Steger's 15-year-old daughter Casey didn't make it home.
There was no wedding. Those girls, the Hadleys, the James, the Stegers, won't have any grandkids. It's permanent. It it's over.
Bill Bond was principal at the time, helping to guide the school through its darkest days. On this day, he meets us at a memorial behind the school.
I never come here and sit and think. It's a sad place for me.
It's a tragedy that was unprecedented.
This group has had to deal with adversity and to overcome that adversity.
Bond stayed on as principal until the last of the survivors graduated. Then he found a new mission.
I've gone to these school shootings. I've been to 15 other schools after a school shooting to try to help the school come back together.
In the years since, Sabrina Steger has also accepted a new reality. Her daughter, Casey, who would have turned 32 this year, had wanted to be a police officer.
It's the Explorer picture. I mean, I can see the pride that she had of being Explorer in her face in that picture. It's one of the latest, you know, last pictures I have of her.
Casey had planned to help others.
And it's ready.
Now, Sabrina does.
Being a part of the fire department has meant that has been a big savior for me. That has really kept me going through a lot of tough times.
Like Casey's high school graduation, her younger sister Becky tearfully stands in to accept her diploma. Also in the class of 2000, Missy Jenkins, who uses a walker to get across the stage.
We knew she was paralyzed. We knew that before she left for the hospital here.
Well, that couldn't have been any smoother.
There is little, if any, substantial possibility or probability that Missy Jenkins will ever walk again.
Missy Jenkins is now Missy Smith, and she's still in that wheelchair. She's married.
Oh, there it is.
The mother of Logan and Carter.
This is going to be awesome.
There are still struggles.
I'm not.
But nowadays, they're different.
Swords.
Logan is 7 by Missy's estimate. That gives her at least 15 years to change her reality. She wants to dance with her oldest son at his wedding.
I do believe I'll walk again. But, you know, if I don't walk in this lifetime, I know that I'll walk in heaven and I'll be okay.
It's that faith and forgiveness that Missy admits has gotten her this far. She famously faced shooter Michael Carneal in court.
I don't have any hard feelings towards you. I'm just upset that this happened.
That day, she promised to live. And she has.
I'm very, very happy with my life, and I'm happy with everything that's come with it. I think that it's a choice on, you know, how you live your life, and I chose to be happy.
Bill Bond chooses to remember not the shooting, but the days before and after.
That was one day. I have 3,000 other days at Heath High School, and that was. The most significant day, but there were 3,000 other days here.
Heath High School graduated its last class in 2013. That school and the county's two other schools merged. Now, while there was talk of closing the school, it's now home to middle schoolers, students that were not even born back on December 1st, 1997. Michael Carneal, meanwhile, is now 31. He received a life sentence, but after serving 25 years, he will be eligible for parole. I'm Lauren Adams, WLKY News.